Hello. In this module of optical fiber communication, we will learn about optical spectral band. Fiber optic communication is mainly conducted in the wavelength region where optical fiber have small transmission loss. This low loss wavelength region range from 1260 nanometer to 6025 nanometer. As shown in the figure 1, with a transmission loss of silica fiber and optical communication wavelength band. First, it also include around 850 nanometer wavelength band. And that is divided into 5 wavelength band referred to as O, E, S, C, and L band. Additionally, 850 nanometer and U band. This second figure is about optical spectral band that include 850 nanometer band, then O band, E band, S band, C band, L band with its range. So 850 nanometer band is the primary wavelength for multimode fiber optical communication system that is combined with vertical cavity surface emitting laser. Among these 5 bands, the O band, that is the original band, is about 1260 nanometer, was historically the first wavelength band used for optical communication because signal distortion due to chromatic dispersion is minimum. It was also because optical fiber produced in the mid 1970s show its lowest loss, the O band. Today, optical fiber show its lowest loss in the C band, conventional band. That is about around 5032 5065 nanometer, and thus is commonly used in many metro, long haul, ultra long haul, and submarine optical transmission system combined with the wavelength division multiplexing and EDFA technology. The L band is a long wavelength band that is around 5065 to 1625 nanometer. It's the second lowest low wavelength band and is popular choice when the use of the C band is not sufficient to meet the bandwidth demand. The same WDM wavelength with the multiplexing and EDFA technologies can be applied to the L band. The loss of optical fiber in S band around 4060 to 5030 nanometer is lower than that of the O band. And the S band is used for many PON, passive optic network system, as the downstream wavelength. The E band, that is extended wavelength band in around 3060 to 4060 nanometer, is the least common wavelength band among the 5. This is because the attenuation of early optical fiber in the E band was highest among the 5 bands due to residual water impurity remain in the glass. After the invention of dehydration technique during glass production, the attenuation of most commonly used optical fiber, that is standard of ITUT, in the E band has become lower than that in the O band. The use of the E band in optical communication is nevertheless still limited, as many as existing fiber optic cables installed before 2000 show high attenuation in the E band. The last is the U band, that is ultra long wavelength band, that is mainly used for monitoring purpose. Though various wavelength bands of the O, S, C, and L bands have come into use with the explosive expansion of internet traffic in recent years, optical fiber amplifier for the O and S band wavelength were not realized for many years because of many technical hurdles. This is the reference for this particular presentation. Thank you.